even with the scribe of A Course in Miracles, Helen Schucman and Bill Thetford, if you kind of look at the history of them and the course, you see that you know, they're basically academia, research psychologists. They're just really eminent research psychologists, two of very prominent research psychologists, who one of them is the boss. Bill Thetford was the head of the department, and he hired Helen. The year that this body was born, 58, was when Bill hired Helen. And then after 7 years of working together in a very difficult working relationship in a Columbia Presbyterian, a very like frenetic and kind of a conflictual work setting where they both were kind of, you know, caught up into all the pressures of being research psychologists, working with students and so on, and grants and all the whole academia package. After 7 years, after he hired her, then she starts hearing this inner kind of, not an audible voice, but like an inner dictation. This is A Course in Miracles, please take notes. Which she's like, you know, psychologists lock people up that hear voices. She's just like, and it just repeats itself over and over. This is A Course in Miracles, please take notes, over and over. And then finally she, no private thoughts, she spills the beans to her confidant, her boss, basically. There's this thing going on in my mind. It's like this is telling me things and is saying this. And she's quite nervous, has a lot of anxiety, as you might have when you usually drug people or lock people up that hear things like that. And so she confesses to Bill what's going on. And he's just holding her arm, comforting her, and saying basically, listen, we'll write it down. Just write it down. I'll type it out. And if it's gibberish, we'll throw it away. We won't tell anybody. So he's very comforting. We'll just type it, write it down, type it, and we'll see. And that's when this is A Course in Miracles. It is a required course, the first introduction paragraph came. And they read it, and he says, this is not gibberish. Let's continue. Well, that continued for 7 years with some breaks, and we have now what we know as A Course in Miracles. And we, Judy Scutch did tell me that they had a psychic reading one time where it was revealed from this psychic reading that Helen had been a student of Bill's in many lifetimes. And when he heard this, he burst into tears because he always thought she was the one that had the great gift, and he was just the sideshow and everything. And Judy said he just burst into tears crying when they gave the long perspective. No, you actually have been her teacher and you've prepared her, and now you're here to comfort her through this mission to bring the course into this world. So we got, you know, from Judy telling me that story, you get the whole context of everything was orchestrated, because Helen had misused her scribal ability in a previous lifetime as a priestess or something, and she had a huge guilt, like she had failed in shame of misusing such a beautiful ability that could have been used as it was this lifetime. It was misused in a previous lifetime, and Jesus is like, don't worry, here we are, focus on right now. Let's go with what's right now. We've got an important mission right now, you know. But he was never using the past as to bring up any guilt, just to show that, no, we're here with a mission to bring an end to guilt. I think there are those that seem to be so willing that they take their readiness and they run, they go so, so high with it. And I think Bill Thetford is a good example of that. You know, he retired from being a research psychologist, moved to California, and then during the FIP event, Judy said, oh, it was probably the last 2 months of his life. He was really the last couple years of his life, he was practicing the course, praying every room he walked into, every situation he went to, every course group he attended. He was just in silent prayer. You know, I'm here to be truly helpful, and really praying. He wanted to see with Christ's vision. He wanted to be a perfect instrument of Christ's love, and he really practiced. And then Judy said his final couple months, he got happier and happier and happier until the day that he laid the body aside, he literally came into her apartment and he was just dancing all over the apartment like Fred Astaire. He was so happy. He could hardly keep his feet on the ground. He got so happy at the end. And then he went out and walked on a sunny day and just very close to her apartment, just laid his body down on the grass right next to the sidewalk on a beautiful, sunny Northern California day. And when they looked for the cause of death, his heart had exploded. And when we think of the heart, we think of the heart of love. It was literally the physical heart. It was a symbol. It couldn't contain. His heart literally burst, and he died instantly. And so that whole parable is extremely uplifting, because he was one of the first two course students, and he took his readiness and he threw his willingness into his readiness, and he just threw it in there, and he just practiced, and he kept coming with his willingness and coming and coming and coming, going for an experience, which is what the course is all about. It's all about an experience. It's not about memorizing concepts. It's not about a theology. It's almost like a trampoline that Jesus wants you to get on for a while and start bouncing like a gleeful little child, and then bounce and go soaring off the trampoline, literally ascending back to the light. That's the purpose. Thank you.